Hey everyone, so today I'm going to show you guys how I do my super quick fast makeup when I'm going to head out the door to run some errands or I just want to look kind of presentable when I'm going somewhere. And today I'm actually going to go get a mani-pedi because homegirl needs a mani. Look at these nails. I do not recommend e.l.f. polishes. This is like 2 days. So yeah, I'm going to treat myself out to a mani-pedi today because I'm off and I just wanted to show you guys my quick routine and the products that I use. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. The first thing I do is I prime my face quickly, and I'm using the Rimmel Fix and Perfect Foundation Primer. It looks like this. It's not my favorite primer, but it does have a little bit of color to it, so it helps to even out my skin tone. As you can see, it has like a peachy color. It's supposed to be like, I guess, color correcting a little bit, but it's not really. It's just a little drugstore primer that you guys can find at Walgreens or at any drugstore. It's really affordable. For this look, I only moisturized my eye area because I am going to be using a tinted moisturizer today, so I didn't feel the need to do the rest of my face. Also, this is not an 80s headband. As you guys know, it's my Mary Kay headband that I use to pull all my hair back out of my face before somebody says, oh my god, she's so outdated. What is she doing wearing that big old 80s headband? Anyways, I'm going to use Aqua Smoothers from CoverGirl. This is a tinted moisturizer, and I'm using number 810 light to medium. I'm actually waiting on a tinted moisturizer that I'm excited to try out from The Balm. I got it from Haute Look, so I'm super excited. I'm just going to use a little bit of this. Again, since this is a quick look, you don't need any brushes. Just put a little bit on the back of your hand, enough to cover your face, and just use your fingers for this. Just apply it lightly. As you guys can see, my skin tone's already pretty much evened out. It looks real dewy and glowy. I'm not one who likes a lot of dewy and glowiness in the summer because I live in Texas and the heat is killer. So you don't look pretty and glowy. You actually look sweaty and greasy. So that's not the look I'm going for. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how I fix that in a minute. I'm going to go ahead and do a little bit of concealer under my eyes. And I'm using Stila Perfecting Concealer. This is a little bit of a more concentrated concealer. Since I'm using something so sheer on my face, and it didn't really help underneath my eyes much, I am going to use this just a little bit underneath my eyes. You need a very small amount of this because it is very, very concentrated. So I pour that onto my ring finger because that is the most gentle finger on your hand. The ring finger is the most gentle finger on the hand, and you need to use this under your eyes to help prevent wrinkles because every other finger creates a lot of pressure and can create a lot of tugging and obviously create some more wrinkles. So I'm just patting this under my eye area and right down beside the nose, so you can see it's already brightening that area up a lot. I'm also taking the excess on my fingers down the bridge of my nose just to kind of brighten that area up and highlight it a little bit. Once all of that is blended in, I'm going to go ahead and do a little bit of eyeshadow. And instead of using the typical eyeshadow, I'm going to use, this is a Mary Kay Icicle Eye Color. I'm not sure if they sell these anymore in this exact packaging. They might have it in a different form. But this is a waterproof eye cream, and it also can act as a base, like a primer. But I use it just as an eyeshadow. You can pretty much use any waterproof eyeshadow or anything that doesn't crease as a color for your eyes. You can use MAC paint pots. You can use the new 24-hour tattoo eyeshadows from Maybelline, which I'm loving, by the way. I barely jumped on the bandwagon. But as you can see, I just rubbed them onto my ring fingers, and I'm just going to spread this evenly over my eyelids. Just want to kind of blend it out with your fingers a little bit. This isn't meant to be a dramatic look. This is obviously a quick summertime look when you're going to head out somewhere, like I said, just to look presentable very quickly. And this will give your face a little bit of color and dimension rather than just looking, if you're pale like I am, just flat and pale. Obviously, this look is a lot faster when I'm not explaining, so I can usually do all of this in about 10 minutes or under. So it works out really, really well for me because my makeup for work usually takes me a good 40 minutes because it's full-on makeup. So as you can see, I added a little bit of color to my eyes, and it's not too much. It's just a nice sheer wash. Then I'm going to go ahead and grab an eyeliner. I'm not going to go around and define my entire eyes, but I'm going to use the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Pencil in 0, and this is just a black liner. You can use whatever color you want. You can even add a little pop of color with a colored liner if you want to, which I've done, like an aqua or a purple. I'm just going to take this into the inner rim of my eye. I'm going to squint my eye so it transfers to the top, so it's kind of tight lining my eyes, and that's it. I'm not going to run it under the lash line. I'm not going to even run it on the top. It's just going to give my eyes a little bit of definition, so this is a trick that I really just love to use. As you can see, my eyes look a little more defined. The color transferred, so it kind of looks like I have a little bit of eyeliner on the top close to my lash line, which I really like a lot. I'm going to go ahead and use mascara next. The one thing that's really fun when you're not wearing eyeliner on the top is that your eyelashes look extremely long. So you want to curl your eyelashes. I'm going to use my Mary Kay Eyelash Curler, which I absolutely love. And I'm going to use my Magnoscopic Maximum Volume Mascara from Estee Lauder, which I love as well. So I'm just going to curl my top lashes, and I'm going to put two coats of mascara on the top and one light coat at the bottom. So my mascara is in place, and you can see my lashes look a lot longer. My eyes look more defined. My face is already starting to come together. The next thing I want to do is add some blush to my face to liven it up a bit. I'm not going to contour or any of that because it's just like a typical day out. And this is Buff from MAC. It's a matte. I meant to say matte and I said MAC matte. What? So I'm going to use this one with my MAC 130 brush. And you can see it already has blush on it. I love this one just to kind of blend out my blushes. And I'm going to use it like kind of as a contour, but I'm going to bring it up a little bit. Not too much though, just to kind of give my face a little bit of definition and color. So as you can see, it really did change up my face. It looks a lot more lively. It looks a little bit contoured. Then I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this shine that I told you guys about. Now, a lot of people might think this is odd because I just put my blush on, but I find that the color comes out a lot better when I'm wearing the tinted moisturizer because it's still a little bit moisturized and the color just looks a little more vibrant. I'm going to use my Studio Fix from MAC, and I use the color NC20. If you guys don't know what this is a powder foundation. I'm going to also use just an e.l.f. brush. This is the powder brush. And I love this one. It's just really good for getting all over your face. And I'm going to lightly tap into this. It's not that you want a full application of powder foundation. You just kind of want to get rid of that shine and give yourself just a tiny bit more coverage. So I'm going to start on my forehead and bring it down my nose area. Just buff that in. And then again, lightly tap into it. And I'm going to go underneath my eye area, on my cheeks, and then by the time you get out here, it's not going to be so pigmented, so it's not going to cover up your blush. It's just going to kind of get rid of some of that dewiness on your face and give you a little more coverage as well. As I'm looking at myself, I want to add a little bit more of a sheen to my eye area since it is summertime. I'm going to use a palette from Wet n Wild. I believe this one's called Half Baked because it doesn't have the name on it, and this is supposed to be a dupe for Kitten. I'm going to take my Eco Tools blending brush, and I'm just going to rub a little bit along my brow bone just to give it a little bit more of a summer sheen, so when I turn my face, it's got like that really nice glow to my eyes. All you need is just a little bit. Like I said, you don't want this look to be too dramatic. You can even use any highlighting color that you have, or any colors that you have on hand to create this look. I'm going to set my lashes with Wet Gloss Lash and Brow Clear Mascara from e.l.f. I just go ahead and just use this because my eyebrows are already dark as it is, so I just have to go over them just to tame them because these are wild little babies. They're always all over the place. My hair is not only long, but my eyebrow hairs get like wild. I'm going to take a little bit of Hard Candy's Baked Bronzer in Tiki, and I'm just going to get my ring finger, swirl it in there because this has a nice sheen to it, as you can see. I'm just going to take this right on my cheekbones, just a little bit. I know we got rid of that greasy, dewy look, but this adds a little bit of sheen instead of the greasy look. It doesn't look greasy at all. And I'm going to take it down my nose just a little bit. And then the last step is I add any sort of gloss or any sort of tinted lip moisturizer. I'm going to be using Simple Colors Gloss. This one is in Sultry Flame. This is a red because I am wearing a red blouse today. And this should come off a little bit sheer, like if I just bit a lollipop or if I was sucking on a popsicle. So there you go, now I'm completely done with my face. As you guys saw, this is actually a really quick look. If I'm not explaining, I'm not talking. Like I said, I can get this done in less than 10 minutes. So if you guys have tinted moisturizers, crease-proof eyeshadows, put those into use for summertime because those are awesome. It's just a quick on-the-go look. Your eyeshadow won't crease. It'll look and stay in place all day. And then a brighter lip actually pulls the entire look together. You can also change this up and use some colored eyeliners. Like I said, you can use a sheer lip gloss. Anything that you want to do, you can use bronzer instead of blush. There's so many different ways you can do this, and you can do it in 10 minutes or under. I hope this helped you guys out, and I really enjoyed making this video for you guys. I'll see you in my next one. Love you. Bye.